New ways of customising stitches in Stitchmastery version 3. Some of the things in this video depend on you having a bit of previous knowledge about using your own user libraries, and if this is something you haven't done before, please see the links that are included in the text below this video. There are tutorials and help files to explain more fully about using your own stitch libraries and some of the things that you'll need to think about when creating your own stitches. This video is focusing very much on the actual editing of the appearance of your stitch. So I'm going to choose one of my user libraries and click to edit or view. And this table view of stitches appears. I'll choose a stitch at random to duplicate and show you how to edit the stitch. So you'll see we have this dialog box opens, which has lots of different things that you can amend to suit, but we're going to look at the appearance. So I've clicked Edit Appearance to open the Edit Stitch Appearance screen. So what we can see here is a canvas for the stitch cell. So we've got, it's one stitch wide, this one, and the original appearance of the stitch is showing. You can see we've got a lot of symbols available, and these are part of the Stitchmastery dash symbol set. So the six libraries that are Stitchmastery sets are preloaded in your program. And at the right hand side, we can scroll down to view more of the symbols that are available within that set. And to choose any of these symbols to put into my stitch, you click and drag, so either using your mouse or your tracker pad, click and drag to select an area of the cell. Now this can be the whole cell or a smaller portion to suit, and then you just simply click on the symbols that you want to add. And you can do this multiple times. As I've shown, you can have multiple symbols in one area, or you can choose different areas to put different symbols into. If you decide that you have made a bit of a mess, as I clearly have, you have a few different options as to how to change what you've done. So we have remove, which behaves like undo in a lot of programs, which as you click will remove the last symbol or character that you placed in reverse order. You can also click reset, which brings you back to the original appearance of the stitch, or you can choose to create an entirely blank canvas by clicking clear. But reset will always bring back what you initially had as the original stitch. Now I'm just going to quickly pop something in here to show you can use more than one of the symbol sets to choose symbols from. You can see these appear. So I can have a symbol from the dot set as well as the dash set. And you can also use fonts in the same stitch. Whichever fonts you have installed in your machine will appear in the drop-down menu. And you can see that there's a option to change the size of the font, so that might be useful if you use cells that are much bigger or smaller than the average. You can change the size of the font to suit. And as you see, the characters for this font have appeared in the screen, and similarly to the symbol sets, we have a scroll menu for fonts that have a lot more characters. The way that you place the characters into the cell is slightly differently for fonts than the symbol sets. So we don't need to click and drag to select an area, but when I click in the cell, you'll see I get a flashing vertical cursor, similar to what appears when you're using word processing programs. And I can either, as with the symbol sets, just click on the characters that I want, or I can use the keyboard to type. And as you can hopefully see, the characters get smaller the more that you put into the one text line. But if you want to have multiple characters, appearing at the same size, you can always just click again in a different area to put in a character at the same size. Obviously, these cells are generally quite small, so the chances of you wanting to have a lot of characters is fairly small, but the option is there. And if you decide you want to use a different font, you can do so. I'll just randomly choose a different font, and this will load, and as you can see, the character that I had selected has changed to the new font. So the other characters that were not selected at the time, they've remained the same. But if I want to go and edit these characters, when I click on, you'll see I get an alert box to say that by selecting this piece of text, it will automatically change the font that it's in. So I can't add extra characters in the previous font unless I change my font at the top here back to the font I was using. But it is helpful if you decide you want to change the font of all the characters. All you need to do is click into the area and click OK, and you can see they change. And when you have the text selected, you can use backspace or delete on your keyboard to remove characters to suit. Similarly to the symbol sets, the remove, reset, and clear options work in exactly the same way. So the most recently edited or added characters are removed in reverse order. So, once you're happy with your new stitch appearance, we click OK. You can see it's different here. I'll click OK again, and you can see my new copy of Slip Purl is here, available to use. So I'm going to come out of these menus just so that I can show you how I actually use this in my chart. So I need to change the library to make sure it's up to date. So this chart is currently using Stitchmastery.english, the default, but I'm going to choose my user dash menu, refresh all text. And as you see, now with the Stitchmastery dash, my knit stitches are signified by a vertical line. If I pull my palette over, open the basic stitches drawer, I'll find my copy of Slip Purlwise with yarn in front, and I can use it in my chart. So I hope that's helpful in explaining to you how to edit the appearance of your stitches in your user libraries.